करते समय बहुत कम।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू वन मोर सेशन ऑफ टुडे। द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे सेशन इज एड्रेसिंग चैलेंजेस इन पोस्ट कोविड स्कूलिंग व्हेन वी ऑल हैव फेस्ड द पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन इन 2020। सो वी आर वेल वर्स्ड एंड मोरओवर वी आर द टीचर्स, सो वी नो व्हाट सर्कमस्टेंसेस वी हैव फेस्ड। सो विद अस वी हैव टुडे Ms. Sangeeta Lal, faculty of Srinath Public School, and she will be taking you to the world of COVID situation, what problems we faced, what circumstances were there, and how we resolved that. Over to you.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you, ma'am. So today my topic is addressing challenges in post COVID school opening. So today we will discuss that it is a big problem. Nowadays COVID allow us to start our school from 1 onwards. So in this topic we will discuss that what are the planning we should do so that when children come around in our school they will be safe. So first of all, everybody knows that what is COVID, because we all were dealing this from since last 2 years, that what is COVID. So coronavirus are a type of virus. There are many different kinds and some cause diseases. A coronavirus identified in 2019, SARS-CoV-2 has caused a pandemic of respiratory illness called COVID-19. As we all know that it is a respiratory disorder, and later it mutated cause lots of various causes in our body. So what you need to know COVID-19, what is necessary and what you need to know COVID-19. So COVID-19 is a disease caused by SARS-CoV-2, the coronavirus that emerged in December 2019. COVID-19 can be severe and has caused millions of deaths around the world, as well as lasting health problems in some who have survived the illness. The coronavirus can be spread from person to person. It is diagnosed with a test. The best way to protect yourself is to get vaccinated and boosted when you are eligible. So as we all know that the how we can be come over from this situation is that we should be vaccinated. Okay, now in this day every organization is considering all the employees that they should be fully vaccinated with the 2 doses. Okay. Yes. How did the coronavirus Okay, so the first case of COVID-19 was reported on December 1, 2019, and the cause was the new coronavirus, later named SARS-CoV-2. SARS-CoV-2 may have originated in animal and changed, so it could cause illness in human. As we all know that how it started from China. And now, and then come back to the human body. Okay, in the past, several infectious diseases outbreaks have been traced to virus originated in birds, pigs, bats, and other animals that mutate to become dangerous to humans. As we all know that this is the virus which is now mutated. Mutated means it is having the same variants are again and again come back and mutate in the next stages. So it is now come back in human bodies. So research continues and more study may reveal how and why the coronavirus evolved to cause pandemic diseases, as it is already declared that it is a pandemic disease. Now we all know that what is coronavirus, what it is, how it comes. Now the main topic is addressing this problem, and we have to deal this problem in the school, that how we can address and welcome back to our students. from standard 1 onwards. So there should be some guidelines which was developed by WHO and our state government so that we should follow that guidelines. So promote and put in place respiratory and hand hygiene, physical distancing and use of mask in transportation such as school buses and accordance with local policy. What are the local policy that was provided by our state government that should follow, and as well as whatever guidelines were provided by our WHO that should be followed. So we all should know that the general guidelines are that hygiene maintain and social distancing and wearing of mask. Okay. Next minute. Yes. So problems that students are most likely to face once the school reopens. Yes. As we all know that lots of problems they can be faced, because after such a long time period they will come back to the classroom environment. So we should be aware of that problems and we should be more careful while handling the student. Okay. So, what should be monitored after reopening of schools? Effectiveness of symptoms reporting monitoring, rapid testing and tracing of suspected cases. Yes, we should be more effectiveness while testing. As in our school, it is also already in practice in entrance in our gardens are already testing the wards who are coming to the school. So already we are practicing this one, and all the policies which is measured on educational objectives and then learning outcomes we are already following, and we should be the effect of policies and measures on health and well-being of children, siblings and staff. Yes, that policy is also we are following that vaccine, that our staff should be fully vaccinated, and we are wearing masks, and we are making social distancing towards the classes, and also we are providing all the hygiene precautions during the school campus. Does WHO recommend students to wear masks in classroom? So yes, it is very important that we should know that does WHO, because being an elder we should be allowed to wear mask, but children, are they allowed to wear mask according to WHO? In countries or areas where there is intense community transmission of COVID-19 and in settings where physical distancing cannot be achieved, the following criteria of uses of masks at schools are recommended. So children aged 5 years and under should not require to wear mask. Okay, means children from age of 5 they should not allowed to wear mask, obviously, because there will be some respiratory problem they may cause, oxygen level will be decreased if they will continue wearing the mask, as they are very small to handle this situation. So they are not allowed to wear mask of children 5 years or under should not be required to wear mask. But for children between 6 and 11 and above are allowed to wear mask, because they will know that how to wear mask, and when if they will feel any suffocation condition, they can be easily able to handle that situation. So they will allow to wear mask. Now, as we all are very much work from home condition, yeah. We all know that digital online classes, physical online classes, everything we are handling. But suddenly we have to come back to the classroom. And being a teacher, it is also very tough situation for us that again and come back to this classroom situation, because we are very useful to taking online classes and all the digital platform which we are using. So what are the benefits of school reopening? So obviously there are lots of benefits of school reopening, because now everything is digital, so we have to provide our service like 24/7. Because students can't be able to understand the concept, then they may call. If parents are not able to understand concept, they may call. But during the offline classes, when students will come back to the school, they will be much be comfortable. They will interact with the teachers very comfortably, and they will be more able to understand the concept. And much the most important that they will be more socialized, because during the online classes they are covered in a box only. Mobile, what is mobile? Because like we are just covering them in a mobile, in like in a box. So when they come back to the school, they will also feel free and come back to the school classroom environment, and they will be happily enjoy and be able to come back and cover all the topics properly. So what are the benefits of school reopening? The decision to reopen school should include consideration of the following benefits: allowing students to complete their studies and continue to the next level. Yes, as I had discussed that they will be much confident and much be easily be available to consider and complete their concept. Okay, essential services, access to nutrition, child welfare, such as preventing violence against children. Yes. So this essential services, access to nutrition, this is like in government school. Like in our private school, they are getting everything. But in government school, like midday meal and lots of other activities, they are missing. Because the students are not able to go to their schools properly. So they are missing lots of activities and lots of benefits in government school. So when school will reopen, it will definitely help them to get all these services. Preventing violence against children. Yes, one of my experience I wanted to share with you, that when I was taking online classes, violence means parents were getting irritated. Like if they are not getting anything and students don't want to sit continuous classes, then what will happen? They forget that online classes is going on, camera is on. They started shouting over the children, or they give one type slap to the children. So this is happening during the online classes because they get irritating. At that initial stage when all online classes was started. So nobody knew that how to do, what to do, and how to deal that situation. So that time parents were also new learner. So if they are not getting and continuous, they have to sit with the student. So they get irritated and they start shouting and giving slapping to the children. They do, beta karo, teacher kya bol rahi hai suno. So this was happen. So we can prevent violence against children. Okay. Now social and physiological well-being. Yes, as I earlier said that due to this online and due to this coronavirus, students or children are totally apart or away from the socialization. Being adult, we are allowed to go outside, but students did not. बच्चे को कहीं जाना ही नहीं, क्योंकि आप being parents, आप सब भी अवेयर होते होंगे. You are also not allow your student or your ward to go outside of the student. Similarly, they are not allowed to go any outside of the ward. So socialization, peer connection already finished. So when they come back to school, little bit they will start socializing themselves. They will get started to the peer with their friend. So this will be one of the best benefit they will get. Access to reliable information on how to keep themselves and others safe. Yes, lots of information we have to give them that how they can be safe and how they can be reliable to the society. Okay. Reducing the risk of non-return to school. Yes, this is a big problem we are dealing. Like lots of students are drop out. Due to any reason, if you are getting, if you go through our documentation work, we find out that lots of students are drop out due to any reason, in government school as well as in private school. So this problem may be solved when school will reopen. Okay, benefit to society such as allowing parents to work. Yes, now parents will very much happy ki ab school khul raha hai. And now our children will come to come 6 ghante ke liye, we will free. So it is very much benefit for the parents. Hai na? Ki nahi boliye. Being the parents, you also want to send your child to the school? Boliye. Is it so or no? Are you?
Yes, ma'am.
So parents, it is very much beneficial for the parents because they eagerly waiting for reopening of school. And they wanted to free their self, at least. It is a part of joke, but yes, the students will learn lots of things, okay?
There are so many kids in Abhisa's house.
Yes, lots of kids are waiting. Next. So, yes, now problems we have dealt, benefits we have dealt, that what are the benefits? Now, what are the challenges? Challenges of maintaining safety precautions. Yes, it is a big challenge for us that what are the safety precautions we should take, because a lot of planning we have to do, as we are doing with our principal sir. He is already planning lots of things, so it is necessary that lots of planning we have to do. Challenges of maintaining safety precautions. Okay, so first challenge will be challenge of hygiene, loss of interest and motivation, lost practice of writing, mental health deteriorating, lack of social interaction and fear of aloneness. Okay, so loss of interest and motivation. Yes, as students were lacking of socialization, and they were getting bored because of this online classes and the daily regular one-way routine. Because they don't have to do anything, they were not allowed to go anywhere. So they were lacking interest. And how we can encourage that interest? By motivating them. Unko motivate karenge. Kaise karenge? That unko batana hoga, we have to tell them what are the why we are opening this school and what are the importance of again come back to the classroom environment. Okay, we have to get their interest. We have to get their interest by talking them that what you like. First of all, we have to take care of their concern and we have to take their interest which is lost due to this condition. Second is most important challenge, that they lost writing practicing. Okay, so can anybody tell me that how we can encourage writing practice? Yes, can anybody tell me how we can encourage writing practice?
Huh? Yes,
thank you, ma'am. So they lost practice of writing because of this online classes they lost writing practice because everything is in Google Classroom. Yes, ma'am, you can sit.
Yes, ma'am. We should give the writing assignments to the students, make the students, we should give them
some kind of writing practice, so that writing homework we can give them, so that they can be in a practice of writing, so that their writing skills will improve definitely.
Yes, ma'am. Exactly, ma'am. Yes, as Manisha ma'am said that we should give assignment to regain their interest in writing. As due to this online courses, the junior kids who belong from standard 1, they lost their writing practice because as all they know, they have to do their exam in Google form, in MCQ form. Okay, so not for the standard 1, or you can find out this condition for the senior classes also, that they lost writing practice. Yes, ma'am? Yes, ma'am. Yes, in standard 10 also.
Not only for single class, starting from nursery to our class 10th or class 12th, everybody lost the writing practice because continuously 2 years they are not in the practice of writing. So, the writing practice must be encouraged among the learners, among our students, so that they can be in a habit of writing answers, because from now onwards our school is going to be offline. So if they are present offline, then they need to give the exams in writing. So that's why the writing practice is very much important.
Yes, yes, Akka ma'am, you want to say something about the loss of writing practice? Nowadays, the students lost the writing practice. So you want to say something
about it? Yeah, we have seen in today's scenario, the COVID situation, they were having classes online, right? So they are basically the practice of writing it was decreased among themselves. Okay, so this is
okay. Thank you, Safaat ma'am. So now come back to Madhu ma'am, that how you can be increased loss of practice writing to your work as you are dealing with the small children. So what are the problems you are facing with them? Can you help?
They are in our kindergarten children, they are writing, we are also providing the, in kindergarten, we also provided writing skills like cursive writing and all. They are writing assignments they are writing. They are not having that kind of problem they are facing in our kindergartens. They are, by one, day one, they are writing skills. Their writing skills are improved.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So, as from my colleagues, we got lots of ideas that how we can increase the loss of writing practices. Okay, so second major problem is that lack of social interaction and fear of writing. So, can you tell me, ma'am, that what is the how you can address the lack of social interaction?
Since students are sitting back at home, we are through the digital mode. So it is not that we are having right in front the students. We cannot, sometimes there is network issue or some network glitch is there. So we are not able to sort out the problem that interaction basically is missing in the classes. So we need to be very well in face-to-face communication while teaching. The digital mode, lost of time, the students are not able to join the classes, or there are sibling problems when there is one mobile and they cannot connect to the classes. So that will help the students coming back to the class and having a proper classroom teaching. That is missing
right now. Yes, exactly, ma'am. That ma'am said the points which we are dealing and coming from the parents, that if they are having only one mobile and siblings are there, they were not able to attend all the online classes. So this is a major problem. And if they are getting Wi-Fi classes, they were lost their network issues or data problem, so they will lost network issue. So every time, like in a day, if any one classes, they lost their network issue. So that's why they lack social interaction. And most of their big problem is that they were not allowing to go outside of the home. And a peer connection is not there. Friendship nahi hai, sirf phone pe hai. Phone pe bhi hai to mummy bole ki kya kar? After taking classes, don't use phone. So socialization is lacking over there. So they were not able to communicate with each other properly. One child I found that they come from for PTM, as we are not allowing, but parents said ki koi nahi tha to mujhe lana padega. saw me, she was very happy and said ki lekin boli nahi rahi, kuch nahi bol rahi, she won't be able to say as she is a very good student in classroom. But when she come back and come in front of me, she was not able to say anything. But in during online classes, she was a very good student. She replying, answering. But now when person is in front of her, she was not able to communicate. So here she is lacking of socialization. So उसकी मम्मी बोलती है, her parents are saying कि मैम she is very good, she liking you a lot, and she said कि मुझे मैम से मिलना है, चलना है. Then I said बेटा कुछ बोलिए, तो she will just keep quiet and she will keep quiet and she will smile. So this is one of the problem that students are not able to socialize with other person. They are not able to come up,
not facing properly.
Yes, they are not facing other person properly. That they are having lots of emotions, expression in their mind, but they were not able. Some are very big sigh. So this week, when they come back to school, definitely they will be more explore themselves. Okay? So that is mental health deteriorating. Yes, mental health deteriorating. So how mental health is deteriorating? Can anybody tell me how mental health deteriorates as we are dealing with this regularly?
So when they come to class, there is one lecture period, right? We have games period, or we have PT period, or music classes. But when they are at home, they are continuously sitting back and studying. So their mental health is deteriorating. They are not meeting their friends physically. They are not meeting their teachers. They are not meeting anyone right out. So that is where their health is being basically disturbed. So they need to be conditioned. Being a human being, you need to, just exposure is required for it.
Yes, exactly. Anyone wants to say that how mental health deteriorating for the children? For the children.
बच्चे मोबाइल से क्लास करते हैं, बैठ करके क्लास करते हैं, कंटिन्यू वो मोबाइल की ओर देखते रहते हैं, उनकी आँखों पर भी असर पड़ता है, और आँखों के असर पड़ने के कारण दिमाग पे भी असर पड़ता है. कई बार बच्चे क्लास कर रहे होते हैं, मम्मी पापा को पता है कि वो क्लास कर रहा है, लेकिन वो बच्चा उससे गेम भी खेल रहा है, मतलब पढ़ाई से दूर भी भाग रहा है, और पढ़ाई से दूर भाग रहा है तो उसका पूरा ध्यान जो है वो खेल की ओर जा रहा है.
यस,
और उसका मेंटल हरासमेंट.
Very exactly. Well said by ma'am. Yes, Basanta, you want to say something about how mental health बच्चों का कैसे खराब हो रहा है sir?
Basanta sir.
आप बताइए कैसे बच्चे का mental health deteriorate हो रहा है? दिमाग पे कैसे उनके बच्चों का असर हो रहा है?
मानसिक विकास की मोबाइल में अच्छा अच्छा गेम्स आ गए हैं, अच्छे अच्छे मैंने पिक्चर गाने इन सबको जब वो देखता है तो उसका दिमाग पर असर पड़ता है, और पढ़ने लिखने छोड़कर वह उस पर ज़्यादा फोकस करता है, तो जिस कारण उसका दिमागी हालत जो है पढ़ाई से दूर भाग रहा है, और दूसरे वृत्ति की ओर यानी काम की ओर उसका मन जो है उनका ध्यान जो है दूसरी तरफ
हो रहा है. अपर्णा मैम एंड मदन सर ने बिल्कुल सही बोला कि एंड प्रवीण मैम सेड दैट कि मेंटल हेल्थ हाउ डिटोरिएट फॉर द चिल्ड्रन एज वी आल्सो गेटिंग हर्ट आवर मेंटल हेल्थ एंड सेशन वाज ऑलरेडी डन फॉर अस दैट हाउ वी कोप अप विद द सिचुएशन. सो सिमिलरली हाउ एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली गोइंग ऑन द चिल्ड्रन माइंड. ओके, सो ड्यू टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस एंड मोबाइल वर्ल्ड, they are now living in mobile world. Still they are living in mobile world. They are not come back to the real world. दुनिया उनकी अब कहाँ है? मोबाइल पर ही है अभी तक, जब तक स्कूल ओपन नहीं होगा. ओके, सो ड्यू टू दिस दे विल अलाउ टू हैंडल मोबाइल एंड इन एवरी एज ग्रुप ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स. इट इज नॉट ओनली द लोअर class student or upper class student, all the age of group of students having lots of problem. जैसे सर ने कहा, मैम ने कहा कि बच्चे क्या करते हैं, they misuse the function of mobile after taking classes. What they do, they used to play some games like PUBG and lots of games names are there. Free Fire, PUBG. Okay, so and they one of the cases we find that one of the student did use it for the going for the next level of this game. They have to pay some amount. Okay, so they use their ATM card of the parents and they lost lots of money. And how they get it? They said ki classes chal rahi hai and I want mobile. And even parents are not aware that they know the security pin of the that ATM card. So they allow and they are saying that they want to take classes and wo classes ke bahar mein kya kar rahe the, level par kar rahe the.
ये एक सर्वे में भी ये एक सर्वे में भी ये सामने आया कि ब्रिटेन में इस ऑनलाइन गेमिंग के कारण हर 6 में से 1 स्टूडेंट में चोरी करने की आदत डेवलप स्टार्ट हो गई है. और ये समस्या वो तो यूरोपियन कंट्रीज में है ही बहुत ज़्यादा क्योंकि वो लोग बहुत ज़्यादा फ्रीली है, बट इंडिया में भी ये लेवल बहुत बढ़ते जा रहा है. आप सुने हो क्या कि बच्चा सुसाइड कर लिया डांट मिला, तो ये प्रॉब्लम बहुत ज़्यादा क्रिएट हो रहा है. मेरे जान पहचान में भी एक बच्चा क्या करता है कि 1,00,000 रुपये किसी गेम में लगा दिया, गया उसका और जब पापा पूछे डांट पड़ रहा है, अरे हम कमा के दे देंगे ना, इससे ज़्यादा आपको कमा के देंगे, टेंशन क्या ले रहे, इसमें बहुत ज़्यादा है पैसा. ये थिंकिंग अब बच्चों में डेवलप हो रही है.
Give some money or invest some money during this online game, definitely they will gain something more. Okay, but when they track, most of the children have to attend suicide cases when they were not able to pay that money. Okay, so yes, these are lots of cases, lots of things which we are which is going in our surrounding and we are dealing with them as our colleagues have said. So due to this. They are lacking mental health deteriorating and this is a big challenge for us that we have to take care of their mental health when they come back to the school environment, classroom environment. Okay, now okay, next one. Now safety precautions when they come back, it is very important that we should take safety precautions. As we all know, these are the basic safety precautions which we should follow: disinfection, wash our hand, and maintain social distancing. Okay, so these are the basic safety precautions which we are applying and implement. Okay, next. Now, hygiene and daily practices at the school and classroom level. Okay, as for the daily practicing, we are washing our hand 20 seconds. We have to wash our hand with disinfectant or alcohol based soap. Apart from that, what are the hygiene practices we should intake in our school and the classroom? Okay, so physical distancing of at least 1 meter between individuals, including spacing of desk. Frequent hand and respiratory hygiene, age-appropriate mask use, ventilation and environmental cleaning, measures should be in the place of limit exposure. School should educate staff and students on COVID-19 prevention measures, develop a schedule for daily cleaning and disinfection of the school environment, facilities and frequently touch surfaces and ensure availability of hand hygiene facilities and national local guidance on the use of masks. Okay, so hygiene is very much important and what are the practices we should apply? That at least 1 meter distance should be there while placing the desk in the classroom. Okay, so that they will not be able to touch or intentionally or unintentionally they will not be able to touch themselves. So this is the one of the most important step we have to take care during the classroom, the arrangement of desk. Okay, so there should be how much distance should be there, kitna hona chahiye distance,
2 gaj ki duri.
यस दो गज की
दूरी,
दो गज की दूरी
यस
सुरक्षा है जरूरी. That means 1 meter distance we have to take in the between the desk. Okay? And spacing of desk should be there. Ventilation, yes, ventilation of the classroom is very much important. Now, there should be proper ventilation. Opening of window should be there. And because why? If there will be any viruses, कहते हैं ना शुद्ध हवा और fresh air हमारे लिए बहुत जरूरी है. So from where we get this air? From the windows, so it is very important that proper ventilation should be there in the classroom. Okay? Yes. Frequent hand and respiratory hygiene. Obviously, we have to frequently sanitize our hand. Being a teacher, we should always have or sanitize our hand during the attending the children, as well as we have to give them training that they will be also sanitized or they will be keep distance, they will be follow all the guidelines which is provided by the government or which is provided by our school campus. We have to train them. हमें उसको training देना पड़ेगा because after such a long time period they are coming in this world, है ना? वो बोल के बैठ के करने में उनको कुछ समझ में नहीं आता होगा but when they come back they will definitely want to share their tiffin, they will definitely want to share their mask, they will definitely want to share their water bottle. अरे वाह आपका तो बेंटन का है, मेरी मम्मी ने मुझे नहीं दिया, मुझे दे दो, मतलब कैन आई शेयर योर बेंटन मास्क. ठीक है तो ये हो सकता है. तो वी शुड ट्रेन देम दैट द हाइजीन मेंटेन द हाई द हैंड वॉशिंग टेक्निक्स एंड द प्रिकॉशंस व्हाटएवर वी आर टेकिंग एंड इंप्लीमेंट ड्यूरिंग द आवर स्कूल. सो ऑल दिस गाइडलाइन वी हैव टू प्रॉपरली ट्रेन देम. Now, yes, listen to the children's concern. Yes, it is very important that we should listen to our children. When they come back to our school, we have to make ourselves from man to mom. हम सिर्फ मैम नहीं रहेंगे, हम सिर्फ टीचर नहीं रहेंगे, वी विल बिकम अ सेकंड मदर फॉर द स्टूडेंट बिकॉज दे वर लाइक वी शुड कंसीडर बिकॉज दे विल हैव लॉट्स ऑफ करियर, लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स दे मे हैव इन द माइंड. उनके दिमाग में बहुत सारी बातें चलेंगी जब वो स्कूल वापस आएंगे. सो वी हैव टू बी एंड ट्रीट देम लाइक अ मदर ऑल्सो. सो वी हैव टू बी पेशेंस. ओके सो लिसन टू चिल्ड्रंस कंसर्न. COVID-19 and school closure impacted many children and adolescents' mental health and well-being. As teacher, it is essential to listen to students' concern. As a teacher, it is important. क्या बोलना है हमको सुनना है, ऐसा नहीं चुप हो जाओ, नहीं बोलना. We should be concerned and we should be listen. अगर उनको कुछ बोलना होगा continuous, if एक ही student कुछ बोलना चाहते हैं, only one student continuous want to say something, we have to be patient and उनको बोलना बोले देना होगा. ठीक है उनकी बातें सुननी होगी. Offer your student the opportunity to have one-to-one conversation with you and reconnect. Yes, we should offer them to reconnect. है ना बेटा ठीक है बोलिए. If they are continuous, they want to say, okay, one by one you just give them chance कि ठीक है आप बोलिए. We have to connect with them. आगे साथ ही किताबों की दुनिया में उनको नहीं डाल देना है ना. उनके लिए वी हैव टू क्रिएट आर एनवायरमेंट सो दैट दे विल बी मोर कनेक्टेड. इफ अ चाइल्ड शेयर एनीथिंग दैट इज पर्टिकुलरली कंसर्निंग प्लीज फॉलो द प्रोटेक्शन और चाइल्ड सेफगार्डिंग सिस्टम इन प्लेस. इफ चाइल्ड इज सेइंग अगर वो बार बार बोल रहा है कि मैम मुझे ये कुछ तकलीफ हो रही है so we should consider and we should listen to them. ऐसा नहीं कह रही ये मतलब बोल ही रहा है इसको ये तो बस बच्चा इरिटेट कर रहा है. It's not like that. We should the reason concern that we should learn we should take their voice properly and हमें उसे connect करना ही होगा है ना. We should be more patient. Now check how children are doing. Yes, it is very important that we should check that how children are doing. After such a long time period, they are coming back to the classroom environment. ठीक है? जो पढ़ा दो साल, क्या पढ़ा दो साल, doesn't matter. We have to check that if they are standard 5, our 10 concept is clear. It's not like we have our syllabus complete karna hai, so we are just continuing and completing our syllabus. It's not like that. We have to check them that how children are doing. वो कैसे कर रहे हैं, क्या समझे हैं अब तक. सो वी हैव टू गो बैक टू देयर बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट आल्सो. ओके, बिफोर टीचिंग एनी न्यू एकेडमिक कंटेंट टू स्टूडेंट्स, टीचर एंड स्कूल पर्सनल शुड टेक टाइम टू चेक हाउ चिल्ड्रन आर डूइंग. हमें चेक करना होगा दैट कितना बच्चों ने सीखा, व्हाट आर द बेसिक, आर देयर बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्लियर और नॉट, है ना. सेवन में आ गए बट आर दे आर reliable for the RPM concept are clear, 6 concepts are clear. So we have to take our patience and we have to first clear that concept and then move on to the next topic. Okay? Remember that children may have difficulty concentrating at first or may need more time to get back into the routine of learning. Provide opportunities for children to take breaks, move around and reconnect with their friends and peers. Yes, we have to remember that they come back after such a long time. So we have to give them time. है ना, एक बार समझ में नहीं आया, so कोई बात नहीं, again we will start. ठीक है, हो सकता है maybe we in 30 group of student 20 may be a A plus student. But for 10, we have to wait and we have to more patience and we have to come back and cook dekhna hoga and again we have to explain the concept. Okay. And we have to provide them opportunities to peer with their friends. We have to give them lunch break. Okay? And we have to give opportunity to peer their friends. So, अपने दोस्तों से बात करें. अब ऐसा नहीं है कि सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग है तो बस वही बात ही नहीं करना, ऐसा भी नहीं है. We will instruct them, उनको सिखाना होगा कि how much distance they will keep, classroom में कैसे बिहेव करना है, and so that they will be getting interest, they will be socialized and they will be having the peer connection. तो वो किसकी जिम्मेदारी होगी, हमारी. Being a teacher, it will be our responsibility to take care of these things also. ये बहुत ही छोटी बात है but real one. When they come back, lots of things we have to do with patience. Okay. Now third is provide children with accurate information around COVID-19. Yes, COVID-19, lots of things is they know about COVID-19. So being a teacher, our responsibility that we have to aware them that what it is, all the myth, all the truth, the story, everything we have to tell them. हर कुछ उनको बताना होगा कि exactly COVID-19 है क्या, so that they will be consider their self in a self in a safe environment. डर के नहीं आना है आपको. They will come back as a hero, not as a problem. डर के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, नहीं ऐसा नहीं है. इट इज आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू टेल देम कि COVID-19 क्या होता है एंड व्हाट आर द सेफ्टी प्रिकॉशन वी शुड टेक सो दैट इट यू आर इन अ सेफ जोन. आप एक सेफ जोन में है सो दैट पेरेंट्स आर आल्सो कंसर्न कि हाँ हमारा बच्चा जा रहा है तो ही और शी विल बी इन अ सेफ जोन. ओके, नाउ यस, वैक्सीनेशन. Vaccination is a very important practice which everybody have to do. Like as adult, we have to vaccinate, all the 2 doses we have to complete it. So vaccination was started. So by May 2021, vaccine developed by AstraZeneca's Bio Serum Institute of India, Janssen and Moderna vaccines were also approved by the WHO for emergency use. In India, Covaxin, COVID Shield and Sputnik vaccines are in practice. Okay, so in India we are generally taking Covaxin, COVID Shield and Sputnik vaccine. Next one. So vaccination for children. Yes, the children who are above from 15 years, like standard 9, 10 or 8, who are having 15 years or more than 15 years student, they now it is considered and it is guideline by the government and WHO that they have also been vaccinated. Okay, so for them co-vaccine only they have to vaccine themselves or they will allow to take co-vaccine, not COVID-19. Okay, so they will allow to take co-vaccine only. Okay, and after 39 days they will allow to take second dose of co-vaccine. So it is also important for the age of group of 15 to 18 years student that they also have vaccinated. So if any student is not vaccinated, it is our responsibility to checklist and to aware them that what is the importance of taking vaccination, and if it is not so, so please make sure that they will take vaccine and then come back to the school. Okay, so it is very important. Now, model good coping behaviors for students, be calm, honest and caring. Yes, so it is like we are the role model of the students. जैसे भी हैं, है तो रोल मॉडल इनके, ठीक है? So we are the role model of the students. अब जब आएंगे तो we have to be the role model of the student. मैम से बात का सफर स्टार्ट हो जाएगा हमारा. So we have to be more patient. ये बार बार मैं बोल रही हूँ, we have to be more patient. क्योंकि दो साल बाद बच्चे आएंगे, तो we have to be more patient. है ना? So teachers can be positive role models for their students. Children will look at you and learn from the skills you use daily to deal with the stressful situation. Yes, student will learn with from us. Student will learn from us that how we are dealing with the situation. If we were getting irritating, agar hum irritated honge, and if we are not following any precautions, then what will happen? They will also doing the same. Our teachers are different. कि मैम सही है हाँ टीचर को नहीं करती है शी इज नॉट इन रेगुलर हैंड वॉश वाली विद सैनिटाइजिंग तो व्हाई शुड वी हम लोग क्यों करें ठीक है यस यस ना बिगनिंग फ्रॉम अस एंड इट शुड बी इन रेगुलर टेस्ट ऐसे नहीं कि एक दिन गाइडलाइन दे दिया बता दिया एंड देन फॉरगेट नो वी हैव टू बी इम्प्लीमेंट ऑल दिस गाइडलाइन रेगुलरली ओके so that they will be able to understand कि ये तो होना ही है this is our life and now this will be our lifestyle okay so we will be the role model for the students and we will be more patient during the handle this little cute monster okay so and because they will learn lots of things from us that how to handle the critical situation and how to be and how to be ourselves stressful during this environment. Okay, next. Yes, counseling and motivation. Counseling and motivation. Can anybody tell me that why I use this topic counseling and motivation for this session? Counseling.
Notorious students we need to counsel because they will not follow the protocols which we put up for they will take it as for naughtiness and they will not follow but it is very much required for the safety of the student. So we need to counsel them and motivate them what are the effects of following these safety precautions.
Yes, exactly. Counseling and motivation for the notorious student but as well as the all general students because when they come back to the school first time so we have to counsel them. कि क्या करना है कैसे करना है हाउ वी विल कम बैक टू द रियल वर्ल्ड इस रियल वर्ल्ड से हमें उनको जोड़ना है मोटिवेट करना है दैट बच्चे नाउ गूगल फॉर्म चला गया ठीक है यू हैव टू कम बैक एंड गिव योर आंसर बाय योर ओन सेल्फ है कि नहीं यस ऑफलाइन मोड है ना अब आपको अपना आंसर खुद से देना है नो मोर गूगल सर्च यस मैम एग्जैक्टली और नो होता है ना गूगल से आंसर मैच करते हैं सो नो मोर गूगल सर्च नाउ यू हैव टू कम बैक टू द रियल वर्ल्ड एंड यू हैव टू बिल्ड द रीडिंग हैबिट राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस एंड काउंसलिंग इज वेरी मच इम्पोर्टेंट इम्पोर्टेंट, बिकॉज जब हम बात करते हैं ना तो समझ में आता है कि किसकी क्या प्रॉब्लम है. ओके, सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी विल डिस्कस, वी विल इंटरेक्ट विद स्टूडेंट्स, सो दैट वी विल फाइंड आउट कि क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हैं एंड व्हाट शुड बी द सॉल्यूशन. ठीक है, तो ये हमें पता चलेगा व्हेन वी विल गेट टुगेदर एंड वी विल टॉक ईच अदर और इंटरेक्ट विद ईच अदर. एंड ऑब्वियसली मोटिवेशन तो सबको जरूरत है. मोटिवेशन तो सबको जरूरत है. क्यों? बिकॉज जितना वो नर्वस होंगे टू कम बैक टू दिस वर्ल्ड, सिमिलरली वी ऑल्सो नीड लॉट्स ऑफ मोटिवेशन, है ना. तो ये बहुत जरूरी है दैट वी विल बी काउंसलर टू देम एंड मोटिवेट टू देम टू द रियल वर्ल्ड. नाउ योगा एंड मेडिटेशन सेशन. यस, दिस योगा एंड मेडिटेशन सेशन इज ऑलरेडी वी आर प्रैक्टिसिंग इन अ स्कूल. So it is very much important कि mental health के साथ साथ we have to take care of their physical health, है ना. So yoga, meditation will help them to be physically fit and as well as mental health के लिए we are there, we are motivating them, counseling them. But yoga will very much helpful to their to improve their and increase their yes physical strength. Like there are some respiratory yoga asanas which will help them to increase their stamina. Okay, so yoga and meditation is very much important for the student as well as for the teachers, as well as for the teacher. Yoga and meditation session, take care of yourself and know your limits. Yes, we should, being a teacher, ye hamari responsibility hai. It is our responsibility that we should take care of them. But ye hamari responsibility bhi hai ki we should take care of ourselves. Hai na? It is our responsibility too that we should take care of ourselves. So yoga and meditation is not only important for the student, but it is also important for the teachers, all the staff or school staffs, so that we can keep ourselves healthy, fit, and we will be ready to handle all the situation which is going on. Okay, teaching can be an extremely stressful profession. Yes, it is a stressful profession because of this, all this phenomenon is going in our surrounding. So how we can cope up with this situation? By taking yoga, meditation, etc. Okay, so teaching can be an extremely stressful profession, particularly now. Make sure to protect your own physical and mental health. We should be take balanced diet, do yoga meditation. Okay, we should be having or build a good sleeping habits and rest, exercise, connect with your friends, family will help us to reduce our stress level. Yes. So make sure that when children return to the school, that they have lots of opportunity to socialize, play, and interact with the peers they have missed for so long. They have missed for so long. So in line with school safety protocols, we should allow them to meet and mess with all the opportunities so that they can interact, play with their friends. Okay, for that we can organize lots of activities which we are already doing, lots of in-house training we are doing for this, and lots of activities we should do so that they can come back and interact with the situation. And okay, I'm next. Yes, so to encourage your students to stick to the rules, it can be helpful to create a do's and does not list with them. So there are lots of does and does not list should be there when we will guideline them. So it will be our responsibility to take care of that list so that they can know that what should do and what should not. Okay, develop a list together around how students will greet each other. Yes, after such a long time they will come. So it is our responsibility that to teach them that how they will greet each other. ऐसा नहीं कि बस एक दूसरे पर बस ये बहुत दिन बाद देखे हैं तो मिल जाना है. Yes, मिलना है, but कैसे मिलना है, how to greet, that we will teach them. Okay. How desk will be arranged? Physical distance measuring during lunch breaks. It is very important that in lunch break we should take care of them. किसी का टिफिन कुछ है अच्छा है तो बस खाना है शेयरिंग करना है तो दैट इज इट इज आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी दैट वी शुड टेल देम कि भाई शेयरिंग अभी नहीं करना है ना जो अपने टिफिन में है दैट इज डस्ट. ओके सो ऑल दीज आर द गाइडलाइंस एंड प्लानिंग विच वी आर थिंकिंग व्हेन द स्टूडेंट्स विल कम बैक टू द स्कूल. Lots of challenges are there. But apart from challenges, we all are ready to handle them. And how we will handle them? Handle with love, handle with care, handle with patience. So that, yes, handle with patience. Okay? So we all are ready to take care of them and we all are ready to welcome our students again in this real world, in this classroom world, and yes, it is our responsibility to take care of them with love. I hope that you all like this session and get lots of information which I wanted to share. Thank you everyone for being a great audience.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to call Manisha, ma'am. So please come on the stage and tell two lines on today's session. Manisha, ma'am.
Thank you, Sangeeta, ma'am, for this very informative session. Now the students will be coming physical. Now we are going to help the physical classes, so the safety measures are our top priority. So thank you for sharing such a valuable information with us. That and the challenges, yes, we are definitely going to face the challenges. So challenges come, then only we grow. So we are ready to welcome them with our whole heart. 2 years being a very long time for them also, for ours also. And right now everyone would surely they want कि हाँ अब बच्चे स्कूल आए हम भी स्कूल आ रहे हैं और जो हम लोग ऐसे पढ़ा सकते हैं फिजिकल मोड में वो उनको ऑनलाइन मोड में हम कितना भी कोशिश करें वो पूरी नहीं हो सकती. तो थैंक यू संगीता मैम फॉर दिस वैल्यूएबल इन्फॉर्मेशन. थैंक यू एवरीवन.
थैंक यू मैम. थैंक यू एवरीवन for attending this session.